My friend, do you know the real Jesus, who laid down his life for you, loves no matter your race, gender, or past sin? Do you know the Father who protects, the Shepherd who guides, Jesus who carries you through trials, catches your tears, cries with you, and laughs with you? Welcome to Encounter the Real Jesus. You will never be the same.
Happy Rosh Hashanah, my friend, and welcome today. We are going to have a wonderful, wonderful time. When I was preparing for the program, the Lord told me that he is going to be personally on this show. Hello, I'm Christine Coleman, and I'm with the Blessing Holy Father Church. It's always a pleasure for me to come and chat with you and share the Word of God with you. You know it's the Word of God that changes everything, our life, our situations. As you know, my friend, many of you, you probably know that this is Rosh Hashanah. Oh, it's one of the feasts of the Lord, which God commanded the children of Israel to observe. So let's read about that in Leviticus 23:24-25. Again, the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to the sons of Israel, saying, in the seventh month, on the fourth of the month, you shall have a rest, a reminder by blowing of trumpets, a holy convocation. You shall not do any laborious work, but you shall present an offering by fire to the Lord." There are seven feasts that God told the children of Israel to observe, and one of them is Rosh Hashanah. Now, Rosh Hashanah is also known as a feast of the blowing of the trumpet. What the blowing of the trumpet reminds you: get ready, assemble yourself, because something big is about to happen. It also reminds us that Jesus is coming again. There shall be a trumpet. Hallelujah! Jesus is coming again for us. Now, my friend, I used not to know much about this feast. You know, I read the Bible, but a few things, if you're not Jewish, sometimes you will not understand about the tradition. And I remember it's in the year 2013. My church was having encounter with Jesus. Jesus began to appear to my church, to 12 prayer warriors, and he began to speak to us. But on Rosh Hashanah of 2013, the Lord came and dressed very beautifully like a king, and he had a crown on his head. I had asked him, "What do you think about Rosh Hashanah?" He told me, "Rosh Hashanah?" Excited, he told me, "It's my wedding day." And from that conversation, the Lord began to teach me the levels of our relationship with God. You know, when you first get saved, it's like you're a baby in Christ. That's why the Bible says they give you milk. But we are supposed to grow. Just like our own children, they don't always have the milk. We don't always give them a bottle, but we give them meat. We give them solid food. So we are supposed to be growing. The way to grow in your relationship, it begins here. This is the book, the bread to feast on every single day. We must read the Bible. It's a map of life, so we know the way. And the Lord began to show me how our relationship can grow to where someone becomes the bride of Christ. The Lord explained many things about being the bride of Christ. And I want to remind us that it's in the Bible where it calls us the bride of Christ. So I wish you all to grow in your relationship, have a great intimacy with Jesus. The Lord asked me, he said, do you know the Jesus who is intimate? The Jesus who loves his bride and marries her. Do you know the Jesus who holds your hands in a trial and he doesn't let you go? The Jesus who dances with you to his song of love and will not let you go. The Lord began to teach us how to dance with him. Jesus who clings to you, a best friend who sticks closer to you than a brother. Then in Revelation 19, verses 7 through 8, my friend, if you have your Bible, let's go to the book of Revelation 19, 7 through 8. It says, let us rejoice and be glad, and give glory to him, for the marriage of the Lamb has come, and his bride has made herself ready. It's not everyone who is a bride. The Lord explained to me, every child of God has a potential to become a bride. But a bride is the one who chooses to be ready. That's what it says here. His bride has made herself ready. It was given to her to clothe herself in fine linen, bright and clean. For the fine linen is the righteous act of the saints. We are his children. We must walk the talk. We must carry out the Bible with action. We must act in compassion and love. And when we do those things the Bible tells us to do, the righteous garments will be given to us. The righteous garments, we must put them on and every day and keep them on because he's coming back for a bride who is ready, who is without wrinkle or spot. Now, in the book of John chapter 3, the Bible talks more about the bride. John tells us that he had so much joy by listening to the voice of the bridegroom. There is a bridegroom because there is a bride. It's not just one person being called the bridegroom and there is nothing else. There is your role to play to be the bride of Christ. The Lord spoke to me. And he said, I desire a strong intimacy. I desire a strong relationship. My friend, even a king in a beautiful palace, having the castle and everything, all the riches of the world, they still need to be loved. Jesus told me to share with you that he wants a strong relationship with his people. He wants to share secrets with his people. But you know, you don't share secrets with anyone. It's the people who are close to you. It's the people who who are sticking closer to you. It's the people who are there for you in good times and in the bad times. In John chapter 3, verse 29, John says, "He who is the bride is the bridegroom." Guess what? Jesus is the bridegroom king. And he desires, if you are not, but he desires each one of us to draw closer, to desire him, and to start being ready so that we may be part of the bride. Hallelujah. "He who is the bride is the bridegroom. But the friend of the bridegroom who stands and hears him rejoices greatly because of the bridegroom's voice." If you hear the voice of the bridegroom, do you hear him calling you and telling you, "I love you, I love you"? My friend, I am going to lead us into the prayer. And I want to pray for intimacy with Jesus. With this encounter, intimacy will follow. Father, draw us after you. Oh, we see your disciple John, who was always with you, the one whom Jesus loved. Father, I pray that we'll be the Johns of today. I pray that we will not settle for less while we can go deep into the king's chamber and share our hearts, and he shared the heart back with us. My friend, prepare with much prayer. Prepare evangelizing. These are the things that make you the bride. I will give them to you. Evangelize, prepare with much prayer. Love him more than you love anything else. And let him be number one in your life. I pray for God to touch you, to give you a desire. I pray for God especially to bless you. And in Rosh Hashanah, the heavens are open. God wants to reveal himself to you. He wants to bless you. Please open your heart in belief, in trust. Because you have a king who loves you. Words cannot describe the love that he has for us. But this is what we can do. We can draw closer and begin to find out how much Jesus loves us. I wish you to have a very, very good, happy Rosh Hashanah. Celebrate. Even in difficult times, remember that joy is a weapon. The joy of the Lord shall be our strength. Rejoice always. Paul says, I will say it again. Rejoice. Smile and be happy because you are loved more than you know. Happy Rosh Hashanah. God bless.
Encounter the Real Jesus is brought to you by Christine Coleman and Blazing Holy Fire Church for healing, deliverance, and intimacy with God. Join our Sunday 7 p.m. revival services, 9250 East Bellevue Avenue, Greenwood Village, Colorado, 80111. For mobile giving, text GIVE to 720-586-4390. Visit theblazingholyfire.com for more options. Till next time, Jesus says, smile and be happy.